Hi everyone! In this tutorial, we'll create a particle background animation using vanilla JavaScript. The animation features particles that move dynamically and react to mouse movements. We also use multiple images as particles. Let's dive into how it works. It includes a canvas element for the animation and a title in the center of the page. The canvas is where the animation will appear. Now let's move on to CSS. Now we import Google Fonts. I prefer this font for the title. Then we reset all margins and padding. We style the body with a radial gradient background. The canvas is made full screen and positioned behind all other elements. Finally, the title is styled with a glowing text effect. We add pointer events none to the title so as not to interfere with mouse interactions. First, we select the canvas and set its size. We also define some global variables. These variables control the number of particles, their speed, and the mouse position. Each particle is an object with properties like size, position, and speed. We use the particle class to manage them. Particles should stay within the canvas by bouncing back when they hit the edges. The first condition checks if the particle's right edge exceeds the canvas width, or if its left edge goes beyond the canvas boundary. If true, it reverses the horizontal direction by flipping the horizontal speed. This checks if the particle's bottom edge exceeds the canvas height, or if its top edge goes beyond the canvas boundary. If true, it reverses the vertical direction by flipping the vertical speed. We make the particles react to the mouse. First, we check if the mouse is over the canvas. This calculation determines how far the particle is from the mouse pointer. If the distance is less than 150 pixels, the angle of repulsion is calculated. We move the particle away from the mouse pointer using this angle. The particle should stay inside the canvas. If a particle goes beyond the left edge, we reset its X position. If it moves past the right edge, we reposition it to fit within the canvas. For the top edge, we reset the Y position. For the bottom edge, we keep the particle fully visible. So we prevented particles from disappearing when they move near the canvas edges. This method draws the particle's image onto the canvas at its current position and size. It represents the image object to be drawn. These are the XY coordinates of the top left corner where the image will be placed on the canvas. The first size specifies the width of the image. The second size specifies the height of the image. The init function creates multiple particles with random sizes, positions, speeds, and images. This line generates a random size for the particle ranging between 40 and 60. It selects a random image from the array of predefined image paths for each particle. This adds a new particle object to the particle's array to include it in the animation. It removes the previous frame's drawings to prevent overlapping visuals. This function also updates and redraws each particle and continuously loops the process. It resizes the canvas to fit the new window size, clears the particle array, and reinitializes the particles. We update the mouse coordinates as the cursor moves over the canvas. Mouse repulsion works properly, but the interaction may appear glitchy when the mouse leaves the canvas area. To solve this, we reset the mouse position to null. This way, the particles behave naturally and only respond when the mouse is over the canvas. And that's it! We've created a particle background animation with multiple images and mouse repulsion. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the bell icon so you never miss out on the latest tutorials. Thanks for watching!